let me introduce you to, as y'all remember, Lady Fire Snow.
Oh, and Queen Theories.
Hello.
Hello.
So we're back, and we're going to go from fun fantasy TV to something real that we just got into.
That we're excited about.
We're excited about.
Shall we?
A lot of people don't realize that Christ only really, Jesus really only preached for 3 years. Preached for 3 years. He started at the age of, 29, 30, and he died at the age of 33.
Yeah.
In 3 years, he changed the world.
Yeah, he knew. He knew what was to come. His father had already told him what was going to happen. He knew it, and he knew he was going to need help to get this done within that time. And so he had some reasons looking for disciples to help him,
spread the word
out that
he was gone.
Yeah, and then to continue it to our lifetime now, right?
Yeah, he makes that statement in the, when he's talking to Matthew, he says, this is about a revolution?
Yeah, I'm trying to, it's bigger, it's more, it's,
yes.
Yeah.
Do you realize how heavily laden your sermon is with these kinds of ominous pronouncements? I haven't even named half of them.
It's a manifesto, Matthew. I'm not here to be sentimental and soothing. I'm here to start a revolution.
Well, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. That isn't exactly...
I said revolution, not revolt. I'm talking about a radical shift. Did you think I was just going to come here and say... Hey, everyone, just keep doing what you've been doing for the last 1,000 years since it's been going so great.
I love to even fast forward to it. I'll watch, like, the part where he's talking to him and where he's talking about gouge my eye out and if you do this, he's saying all the... It's a lot of negative stuff, you know, like...
Because he thinks literal. Yes. Very spectral, right?
I think literal, so I totally think like that.
The whole truth.
You know I won't be offended.
It's, well, very striking, but if I do the math in terms of good news and bad, it seems like there's not a lot of good news. Anyone who looks at a woman with lust has already committed adultery. Doesn't that make everyone an adulterer? If your right eye causes you to sin, gouge it out. Wouldn't that lead to an entire population of people walking around with only one eye? Oh, and this one. If anyone were to sue you and take your tunic, let him have your cloak as well?
You know, trying to come up with a prayer.
Yeah.
And he's thinking and thinking and thinking. And it's so funny because, of course, you know, Jesus did not have to think, you know.
Matthew.
God was giving him all the... But it was Matthew.
Bye-bye. I've got it.
The opening?
Yes.
What is it?
A map.
A what?
Directions. Where people should look to find me.
Hey, you're going to help me come up with this. We're going to do this together. So they could have that connection and that bond. And the answer was right in front of him, right? The prayers and the words that he needed. And as he's praying, he's looking at each of his disciples. And seeing.
That is one of my... favorite. I think that's one of my very favorite. Oh, remember Matthew asked him before he woke him up. He says, don't you think this is going to cause a lot of trouble? Or he said something like that. And he said, Matthew was like, but I mean for us.
Yeah.
You've just returned from detention. Will these teachings make things worse?
I'm here to make things better, not worse, Matthew.
But I mean, for all of us who love you,
promises.
And then he starts the sermon.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when others revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven.
Yes. But how is it the map?
If someone wants to find me, those are the groups they should look for.
Just because Jesus didn't need Matthew's help,
right,
doesn't mean that he didn't use Matthew.
He wanted to have that bonding with him. He wanted to have that
with each of his disciples.
And he does that. Yes, he does that. Gets to know them and sees what they are capable of. See what, you know, all that stuff to think about how and what he's going to give them for later. What gift he's going to give them for later. It's beautiful how they put that together.
I did too.
Don't forget to like and subscribe. And yeah, we'll stir up the waters a little bit.
Yeah.